Hello, my name's Peter Cook and I'm the Director of Education for Deal Music and Arts. We're based in Deal, a lovely little seaside town in the southeast of England. Come and visit us. Today we're going to have a fantastic concert given by the Bold As Brass Quintet. That's a lot of B's, so let me explain what they mean. Bold As is a project. It's for training young people how to play brass instruments. Some of the people watching this will probably be part of that project. So hello to you all, and I hope you really love the concert. There's all sorts of music that's going to be played, and I think you're going to enjoy it. A brass quintet, well, that's instruments made out of metal, brass, and it's also five brass instruments. We'll introduce them later, but just to say it's led by Phil White. So let's start off with a magnificent fanfare. Wasn't that magnificent? I love a fanfare. Okay, the next piece that we're going to hear is a very well-known children's nursery rhyme that I think most children learn when they go to school. It's called Frère Jacques. It's a French tune, although you might know it by its other name, I Hear Thunder. Anyway, don't worry, because they're not going to sing it, they're going to play it, so the tune stays the same. But I want you to notice a few things as you listen to this tune. I want you to really notice how the melody is passed around between the instruments to create different effects and to make it more interesting. See if you can tell which instrument is playing the tune and notice their different tonal sounds as they're playing it. Some of it is very funny. And in fact, there's another tune that is kind of played towards the end of the piece by the tuba. I wonder if you can tell what that tune is. And lastly, there's another thing that happens with the trumpets. The trumpets stick something in the end of their instruments. Yes, I want you to have a real listen as to why they stick something in the end of their instruments. The thing they're sticking in the end of their instruments is called a mute. So have a really good watch and a really good listen. Enjoy Frère Jacques.
Thank you.
Didn't they play well? What a great tune. Did you get the extra little nursery rhyme at the end? Well, it was called Pop Goes the Weasel. Half a pound of tuppenny rice, half a pound of treacle. And it was played by the tuba right just at the end. Anyway, don't worry if you didn't get it. And the mutes were put into the trumpets to make it sound a little bit more mysterious, I always think anyway. It really changes the sound, doesn't it? Sounds really interesting. It's called a mute. Okay, so now we're going to get to know the band and we're going to hear who they are and they're going to tell you a bit about their instruments. So let's go over to them. So here is our fabulous brass quintet. Let's introduce them first of all. So on the left of the screen, you've got Tim and he's playing that lovely silver trumpet. And next to him, there's Lindsay playing the French horn. And next to her, there's Ben playing the tuba. And then to his left, there's Phil playing the trombone. And finally, right across on the right-hand side of the picture, there's Paul playing another trumpet. So, how do you make a sound on these instruments? Well, in fact, it's pretty easy. You blow down the tube and you make a buzzing sound with your lips. It's the buzzing sound that you make with your lips that is the vibration that starts the sound. So you need to do both those things. Blow down a tube, make a buzzing sound with your lips. And you can do that with anything. So you could even do it with a hose pipe. In fact, we're going to start off by listening to each of the players play their instruments. But let's start with the hose pipe. Here's Tim. Okay, let's get really in close to have a good look at these instruments. So all the instruments, as you can see, are different shapes and sizes. And basically, the bigger the instrument, the lower the note, and the smaller the instrument, the higher the note. But there are also different ways that the players can change the notes, can change the pitches that they're playing. So if we look at the trumpet that Paul's playing, you can see he's got three buttons he can press down to change the sound. These are called valves, and when you press one of those down, it changes the direction of the air to go along a different tube, ingeniously, to make a different sound or different pitch. The trombone only has one tube, or it looks like you only have one tube. In fact, you have one tube that fits over another tube so you can slide in and out. It looks almost like magic, doesn't it? But you can slide the tube in and out to change the pitch of the notes. The tuba is a big, big instrument. It's the biggest, the heaviest, it's heavy metal, and it plays the lowest notes. And Ben has got three valves with his right hand, and he's got one valve you can just see with his left hand, and he can change the pitch to play really low notes as well. Let's move on now to the French horn, and you can see that the French horn is a really beautiful looking instrument, full of curves and bends, and you can see little wiggly pipes there as well. And when Lindsay presses down the valves, it changes the direction of the air, just like the trumpet and the tuba, and it makes the notes different, sometimes lower, sometimes higher. It depends how long the tube is. She also has another way of playing it. So if you look carefully, you can see her right hand goes up inside the bell of the instrument. That's the end of the instrument, the kind of flared end that actually looks like a bell. She puts her hand up the inside of the instrument, and that changes the tone and makes a really lovely sound. And the last instrument we're looking at here is what Tim is playing. It's on the left side of the picture, and it's called the natural trumpet. And the natural trumpet came before the trumpet that Paul is playing on the right-hand side. And it doesn't have any valves at all. So in other words, it can only play notes of something called the harmonic series. And the harmonic series is a natural series of notes that you can get when you blow into a tube. So any tube that you blow into and make a buzzing sound to make the vibration, you can play the harmonic series. And we're actually going to hear a piece where we just hear two natural trumpets. So you can see from looking at the instruments that it's a real match between the invention that has gone into making the instrument, the science behind the instrument, and the skill of the performer in practicing the instrument for hours and hours and hours to get really good at playing the instrument and controlling the sound. So here's Tim again, and he's going to play the natural trumpet, and we're going to hear just one note, and then we're going to hear him actually playing the harmonic series. Now let's put two natural trumpets together, so you can see them there. They look a bit far away, but on the left there is Tim, and on the right there is Paul, and this time he's playing a natural trumpet too, and they're going to play a special piece which was just composed for the natural trumpet. And let's hear the other instruments play through some of their harmonic series. So remember, they're not pressing down the valves for this. They don't need to, because they can change the note just by changing that vibration they make with their lips, that little buzzing sound. So as they increase the quickness of that vibration, then the note will get a little bit higher. through the harmonic series, and you'll hear it go up and down without them moving any slides or any valves. So now, Paul is going to play the harmonic series on every valve combination on the trumpet. See if you can tell how many different harmonic series he can play. So they were all notes from the harmonic series, and I must say they made it look really easy, but it does take a lot of practice. But once you get it, it means you can play all the notes with the valves, and you can also play all sorts of notes on the harmonic series as well. So then you can really express yourself with the instrument and play some great tunes. So let's go back to the music and see all that in action with a great piece by John Philip Sousa. It's called Stars and Stripes Forever, and this one features two trumpets as well as the French horn, tuba and trombone. The next piece you're going to hear today is by Claude Debussy, a French composer who lived about, well, over 100 years ago. He died in 1918. He wrote lots of studies for the piano, and the great thing, of course, about the piano is you can play lots of short notes very easily. It's harder to play long notes on the piano, but he found a way around that by pressing down the right pedal, which means the notes continue for much longer. It also means you can merge the notes or kind of mush them together to make all sorts of interesting sounds. Of course, today you're going to hear it on brass instruments, but listen out particularly for this wonderful melody on the French horn. Lovely, isn't it? And that's contrasted by lots of fast and rhythmic short notes. This piece was based on what was called a cakewalk. A cakewalk was a sort of dance, sometimes quite a funny dance, and people would do the cakewalk, and then the winner with the best dance would get a cake. So maybe you could make up your own dance to this, and the winner in your family or class could get a cake. The next two tunes are both rousing numbers, but in different ways. The first one is much more jaunty, I would say, and the second one much more military. So let's give you a clue for the first one. The clues are A Man and His Dog, Wensleydale Cheese, A Great Inventor. Have you got it yet? That's right, it's Wallace and Gromit, or the theme from Wallace and Gromit. And the second one is by Lieutenant F.J. Ricketts, and it's a rousing march called Colonel Bogey. Enjoy! For the next piece, let's really show off the trumpet players. The trumpet is a fantastic instrument which heralds all kinds of occasions. And here's a piece which dates from about 1700 and was written by Jeremiah Clarke, who was the first organist of St Paul's Cathedral. And it's called the Trumpet Voluntary, or its real name is the Prince of Denmark's March. And here it is. Thank you. Well, that really is a fantastic sound, isn't it? And you might have noticed that the instruments they were playing for that piece were slightly different to the ordinary trumpets. In fact, they were kind of smaller. They were about half as big. And that means that they can play those really high notes. And if you were looking really carefully, and perhaps if you were a trumpet player yourself, you might have noticed that they had an extra valve. So normally, a trumpet has three valves, so you can press down those valves to make the different notes. But on those piccolo trumpets, they had an extra valve. Okay, we've got a couple of more pieces for you as part of the concert, so I hope you've really been enjoying it. The next piece, I know you will know. Now, it's one of the longest running TV theme tunes on television, and it's been running about as long as I've been living, so at least 30 years old. And it's written by Barry Stoller, and he made this piece originally, I think, just for trumpets. So it's very appropriate it's played by a brass quintet. It's called Match of the Day. Well, we've come to our last piece, but I hope you've enjoyed listening to the Bold As Brass Quintet, have learnt a little bit about the instruments and how they play, and perhaps even thought about having a go yourself and taking up a brass instrument too. The final piece is by Joseph Horowitz. It's a piece in three movements from the Music Hall Suite. So sit back, relax and enjoy it, and we'll see you again soon. Thank you.
Thank you.